tonight. The musicians and everybody else, we respect the places. At this time, I'll call Kenesha Doyle to do the scripture.
John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life.
Job, he got his 100%. just I'm like, it's a good testimony. My coworker, my ex-coworker, I used to work for, her daughter is going through some treatment. So she actually, it's been a year since I talked to her. But how do you know that if you keep the faith and you show a light, you never know who's watching you. We say this all the time in church. So after a year of not talking to her, she hit me up on Monday and just texted me out of the blue. Now, like I said, it's been a year. And she told me to pray for her daughter. Was going to try to, they want to see if she need surgery for this type of treatment, cancer. And, God is good. She went, she did her, I guess when you go get an update or whatever, she don't need surgery. They just gonna keep on the message she got. And you just gotta keep a light and keep God praying up. And I pray my strength in the Lord.
Mothers tonight to bring her up.
Yeah. straightened that narrow path, and I just ask that you bow your heads and go with me as I go into prayer on tonight. Oh, Father God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for this chance and this opportunity that you laid before us, Lord. We thank you, Lord God, for another opportunity to come into your house and give your name reverence and to give you praise, Lord. Lord God, we know, Lord Jesus, that it's deliverance that's in your name. The healing, Lord, is in your name, Lord. And salvation is in you as well, Lord. Lord God, we commit, Lord, the remainder of the service into your hand, Lord. Lord God, we ask on tonight, Lord, that you open up the eyes and the ears of your people, Lord. Lord God, we ask, Lord God, that you bring hearts on tonight, Lord. Lord God, on tonight, Lord, we ask, Lord. Lord God, that you stir up your mind, Lord. Lord, we ask on tonight that you give us something, Lord God, to fight with, Lord God. Lord Jesus, Jesus. Lord God, help us, Lord, to stand on the truth, Lord. Lord God, that you have brought up in us, Lord. Lord God, and we're so grateful tonight, Lord. Lord God, to have a pastor, Lord, that stands on your word, Lord, that tells us to pray, Lord. Lord God, oh Jesus. Lord God, I remember, Lord, a mother saying you gotta pray to stay, and you have to fast to last. Lord, Lord God, be with us, Jesus. Lord God, put something on the inside of us, Lord. Lord God, let us begin, Lord, to let us go in our secret chambers, Lord, and pray unto you, Lord, to go in, Lord, and tell on groves and altars that we have built, Lord, to the things of this world, Lord. Lord God, you say, Lord, that if we humble ourselves, seek your face, and turn from your will, from our wicked ways, that you will heal our land, Lord. Lord God, oh Jesus, Jesus. Oh, oh Lord. Lord, help us begin to cry out unto you, Lord. Lord God. Lord God, because we don't think, Lord, things change when we pray, Lord. If it don't change the situation, Lord, it'll still change our mindsets on it, Lord. Lord God, so we need you, Lord. Oh, Jesus. Lord God, come in, Lord. Come in and talk with us, Lord. Tell us what you want us to do, Lord. Order our steps, Lord. Lord God, give us your thoughts, Lord. Lord God, oh, Jesus, Jesus.
We're seeking them, but yet we're still running after the things of the world.
What are you seeking for tonight? Holy Jesus. Oh, seek me until to find something. Oh, hallelujah. Seek is to search out by any method, specifically in worship or prayer. By implication, to strive after. Y'all, we gotta strive. The Bible says strive to enter in. This is a pressing way. This ain't no one day I'm gonna do it and tomorrow I'm not, but this is a way you gotta be consistent with the Lord. He's looking for a people that's gonna be obedient to what his word is saying. We can't just, like Co-Pastor was saying on this morning, we can't just be hearers, but we have to be doers. We can't, Pastor said it, she said you can't say you believe in holiness and preach holiness, but not live it. See, this is something that you gotta live. See, this is something that people gotta see in you. Because like I was telling somebody, I said, people think they can fool you, but the devil knows what's real and what's not real. He can say, because he know the word. See, he can't live it, but see, he know it. So we can't sit around here and think we, you know, tricking God. We can't even trick the devil, so either you're going to be real or you're going to be fake. This ain't no way that you can choose one day, oh, today I'm going to be holy. I'm going to wear my dresses to the floor. And tomorrow I'm going to go and put on my pants and my jewelry and my makeup. No, 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 no. This is not something that you can play with. You better get right with the Lord. Because I'm telling you, he's seeking for such that's going to worship him in spirit and in truth. You can't say that you holy and you got the Holy Ghost and you don't look it. People love to say God don't look at your outward appearance. Yes, he do. He say present your body a living sacrifice. That means you got to be clean from the inside out. And you can't dress it up on the outside and still be messed up on the inside. You can't go listen to your blues tomorrow and then the next day you want to praise the Lord and listen to your gospel. You better choose this day whom you are going to serve. All these different religions coming about and we get itching ears. We're supposed to be saints of the living God. We're supposed to be serving the high priest. How you going to serve the high priest and bad boy at the same time? He said you can't serve two masters. You must love one and hate the other. What is wrong with you people on Zion? Holy Jesus! You think you're going to be in the nightclubs and go to all the different parties and think that you still can serve the Lord? Amen. Sit your butt down. You are deceiving. And let people be deceived. That blood is going to be required at your hands. Like I tell people, this is the truth. And this is what I'm going to stand on. I can only say what the Lord tell me to say. I can only do what he allowed me to do. I can't add to and take from this thing. You see, because if I do, I'm putting curses on myself. And listen, I know I already did put too many curses in my younger days. I ain't finna put them on now. So when I told the Lord I was going to serve him, I'm going to serve him with my whole heart. You see, because I can't play with the Lord, because I ain't trying to die and go to hell. See, if I'm going to die, I'm going to die one death. And then when the Lord come, I'm going up with him. I'm not dying and then going down with him. No, 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 sir. I can't do it. I don't know about nobody else. People are out here playing with your souls. You can't play with your soul. You get one soul. People be saying that, oh, people are brain dead. But it's the soul. When the soul leave the body is no longer. Why you think when the Lord told Ezekiel to go to the valley of dry bones? See, when he breathed the breath of life in him, that's the soul. When we got the life of God in us, that is our soul. Hey, man, I didn't come to say that on the night, but we just gonna let the Lord have his way. Because he know what we need. He know what we need on tonight. We gonna go to the scriptures, and the first scripture we're gonna be reading is come from Isaiah 55:6. Thank you, Jesus. Y'all, I just love the Lord on tonight. He's been so good to me. Y'all just don't understand. I've been asking the Lord some things I haven't even been saying out loud. It's just been in my heart. And the Lord has been answering them for me. I'm telling you. The Lord is stirring up my prayer life, and I'm thankful for it. Because if you don't have a prayer life, you ain't got nothing on tonight. Lord. You better get into your prayer chambers, people. Because God is calling for people. And you can't hear the Lord if you ain't praying.
Come on here.
People around here talking about they hearing from the Lord. You ain't even seeking him, so how you hear from him?
Amen.
You got to first seek him. He says, seek me and you shall find me. Knocking the door will be open. But see, that door won't always be open. He said in his word, his spirit won't always strive with man. So you better get it while the going's good. Because it ain't always going to be good. Amen?
Amen.
Have everybody gotten to the scripture? Okay, and it reads, seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. See, the Lord is very real and near on tonight. See, we can just reach out and touch him. If we really want the Lord, he is here for us. Mm-hmm. And we're going to go on to Jeremiah 29:13. Say amen when you make it.
Amen.
And it reads, and ye shall seek me and find me when ye shall search for me with all your heart.
Yeah.
See, that's the thing. We want to give the Lord a piece. We want to give him a little pinky toe and say, now, Lord, I'm going to keep the other nine and the rest of my body. Now, you can just take that toe, but the Lord say with all your heart, he want everything that's in you. He don't want a piece. He don't want to just tear down a piece of the stony wall that we have put up, but he want to tear it all down. See, like, I might keep repeating myself on tonight. But like I said in the word, he's seeking for such that will worship him in spirit and in truth. He said in spirit and in truth. So in truth means in the natural. You don't just want somebody that's going to come and give him a little service on Sunday. But he wants somebody that's going to give him their life. Because see, he first gave us his. So why is it so hard for us to give him ours? Amen. Let's go to Matthew 6:33. Amen. When you get there.
Amen.
And it reads, but seek ye first the kingdom of God. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things shall be added unto you. We first have to seek the kingdom. See, we mess up because, you know, it's this old flesh. We're wrapped up in this flesh. See, sometimes it's so hard for us to deny his flesh. You know, sometimes it pulls on us. But that's why we're supposed to crucify it daily. If you're not denying your flesh daily, then you can't be, oh my goodness, I didn't expect myself to fall, but you weren't denying your flesh. So how were you expecting yourself to fall? You weren't fasting, you weren't praying. The Bible say some of these things come by fasting and praying. So you can't just say, oh, I'm going to just pray. You got to fast sometimes. You got to push back your plate. People around here talking, so I'm going to fast off the TV. I'm going to fast off. No, push back your plate. Push back your plate. You got to flip your flesh. Stop right here playing with the Lord. In the Bible days, when they fasted, they didn't drink or eat.
Come on, man.
So you better stop playing with the Lord. Thompson. You just stop. I'm not going to go to the gym today because I'm fasting. I'm only going to eat chicken and turkey because I'm fast. That is not no fast. That's a diet. Stop playing with the Lord. He is not Weight Watchers. He said, push back.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, we're going to move on. sometimes the Lord just cracked me up. Oh, Jesus. We're going to go on to Luke 13:24-27. And this scripture going to tie in with the strive, because when you're seeking for something, you're pressing, you're not letting up, you're going and you go, because when you're seeking the Lord and you're really trying to find him, you're not going to say Jesus three times and say, well, he ain't come on, stop. No, but when you're seeking for Jesus, you call on him. You call on him until you feel him. People saying they Holy Ghost feeling, ain't even touched the fire, haven't even been in the presence. of the fire? How have you received the Holy Ghost and you don't even know what the Lord feel like? You ain't even felt that because he's a consuming fire. He give you a fresh wind. He got that anointing that destroys the yoke. You still got a yoke on you from 30 years ago that ain't never been destroyed. How you got the Holy Ghost? How you seeking for him? You ain't seeking for the Lord. No, you're seeking for somebody. It ain't the Lord. You're seeking to stay in your mess. That's what it is. Now say amen when you make it to the scripture. And it reads, try to enter in at the straight gate. For many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in and shall not be able. When once the master of the house is risen up and has shut to the door. It says, when once the master of the house is risen up and has shut to the door. He said in his word, your spirit won't always strive for men. He said one day you won't be able to find them. Amen. And it says, and ye begin to stand without and to knock at the door, saying, Lord, Lord, open unto us. Hey, them five foolish virgins, they went to knocking. They went to knocking. I hear a song in my mind, head playing by Daryl Snow saying, you've been knocking, but you can't get in. That's what sin would do. Amen. Glory be to God. See, sin will keep you from a lot of things. A lot of things that God wants to give to us. We can't dwell in the world and think the Lord gonna bless us in our midst. He don't do that. See, because that contradicts his word. He said, be ye holy as I am holy. So we can't say that the Lord blessing us and we out there two-stepping, you know, with the thugs and, you know, the strippers and stuff. No, it ain't gonna work like that. If you ain't trying to say they soul, you need to get from around them. Because the Bible say the strong man will win. So you better get from around them. If you ain't got something, if not something, but the Holy Ghost. If you ain't got the Holy Ghost and you're not standing sure on that foundation, that cornerstone, you got to be on the cornerstone. See that cornerstone that the builders refused the first time. You see, but when he rose from the dead, a lot of them still refused them. But we got to build up on Jesus. I hear a song saying, he set our hope on things eternal. See, Jesus is the only thing that's eternal. See, he said everything is going down but the word. See, that's why we got the word. But people want to flip it, want to change it, want to switch it. They want to read this scripture here, don't tell you about the other part. They say, the Lord will give you the desires of your heart. But they don't tell you the first part. He said, if you delight yourself in me. You got to delight yourself in the Lord if you want the desires of your heart. And your desire should be the Lord. Because he said, where your heart is, there also is your treasure. So if your heart is in heaven and your heart is stored up upon Jesus, then that's where your treasure is. You won't be looking for no house and no car and no fine jewelry and no nice shoes. But you'll be looking for Jesus. No matter what you do, if you're doing something for somebody, you won't be looking for no money in return. But you'll be looking for Jesus to increase that spiritual man. See, this thing is on the inside. It ain't with that. This ain't nothing in the natural. But this is the spiritual. He said, be spiritual minded. He said, a corner mind is enmity towards God. That means he hated. It's an abomination. So why are we sitting here setting our hope in corner things and buildings and houses and cars and clothes? We need to stop that mess. God is looking for a peculiar people. He's looking for somebody that's going to serve him and that's going to do what he said. You around here, you thinking that, oh, I'm serving the Lord today, but then tomorrow I'm not. And you think he's going to keep on letting you dwell in his house, but he's not. Amen. See, you going to be cast out. Because the word say judgment started the house. You read it today, it was in the word. See, some people, they just take what somebody tell them. But when you search these scriptures and you write in the Bible, see, the Bible says study to show yourself approved. Hey, glory, glory, glory. And I'm going to search. You can't tell me anything because I'm going to look in this word and see if it be in there. Amen. And it says, open unto us, and he shall answer and say unto you, I know you not whence ye are. Then shall you begin to say, we have eaten and drunk in thy presence. See, it's going to be some they done ate from this table, from this truth. And guess what he's going to tell them? And then they also said, and thou hast taught in our streets. See, the Holy Ghost was amongst them the whole time, but they didn't want to get it for real. And then he said, but he shall say, I tell you, I know you not whence ye are. Depart from me, all ye workers of iniquity. He's saying his word that people are going to say, but we cast out demons in your name. You see what them sons did? They went over there telling that demon, come out by the name of Jesus, which Paul preaches. But see, the Jesus that Paul was preaching wasn't in them. The demons came out, but they attacked them, and they beat them out of the clothes. Amen. Now let's go on to Matthew 7:7. Say amen when you make it. And he said, ask and it shall be given. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh, receiveth. And he that seeketh, findeth. And to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. Amen. He said, it shall be opened. If you're knocking and you're knocking in a pure heart. See, people don't want to tell you that part. You got to have a sincere heart. You got to be real with the Lord. You got to be transparent. You got to come before the Lord and say, Lord, like Isaiah said, I'm a man of unclean lips. I dwelleth amongst a people of unclean lips. Woe is me. We were out here thinking, oh, Lord, I'm perfect and I'm good. Now give me the Holy Ghost. No, that's not how I work. What's wrong with you? Do you think you're that good that the Lord owe you something? If anything, we owe him. We owe the Lord. We owe him everything that's in us. Everything that we get, we should want to give him more than 10%. We ain't even going to get on that part. Amen. Don't want to get the Lord none of your time. You make that he give you money, you don't want to give him no money. He give you love, you don't want to give him no love. He give you happiness, you don't want to give him no happiness. He give you joy, you don't want to give him no joy. He give you peace, the peace that surpasses all understanding. And then you wonder why your mind gets to walk. Because he said, whosoever mind is stayed upon me is kept that perfect peace. You haven't kept your mind stayed upon the Lord. How you think the Lord is supposed to bless you? How you think the Lord is supposed to be the joy in your life when you ain't kept your mind stayed upon him? Put your mind on the Lord. Get your mind off the world. So much going on in this world. I was reading my Bible the other night. Y'all pray for me. Pray to the Lord. Strengthen my reading life. I don't read like I should all the time. I might read the scripture here and there, but I need to get back reading like I was. But I was reading. I'm just going to be honest. That's just me. I'm going to be honest with the Lord because I know I need the Lord every day of my life. But I was reading in the Word, and it was talking about all these different gods that the children of Israel turned to. The Lord will bring them out. They'll go back into some mess. And I was just reading upon all these different gods. And I was looking, and I just went to scrolling. I went to looking. I be searching words, y'all. I like to look up words and stuff because I got to know what stuff means. I can't just be, you know, out here looking at something. And then I go and tell it to somebody. And I can't even explain it and break it down to them. I got to be able to break it down. You see, so I was reading up some words. They got all these different religions out here. They got a religion called heathenry. Saying that they are heathens, saying that they go after all kind of things. They got people out here that are witches, that call themselves witches, and we think we don't need to buckle down and pray. We think it ain't time to gird up our loins and put on the whole armor of God. What's wrong with you? It's all kind of manner of mess going on in this world, and we sit here acting like, let's have a good time. If you ain't having a good time in the Lord, you need to sit down. You need to go back. Go back to your first love. Return back to when you first believed. Go back to that old landmark. It's so funny because my generation, they want to leave the old landmark. They want to say, oh, you can be like this. And the Lord still love you. No, he don't. He do not. No. He don't love that mess that you in. He just say the Lord chasing those that are his. So if you don't like that chastisement, then you're not none of his. You're not his child. You a bastard. If you ain't trying to live right for the Lord, then what is wrong with you? People accepting homosexuality and all kind of things. People saying, I didn't believe in that, but now I got a child. People, we supposed to be seeking after the Lord, but we putting our children And we putting other things upon that pedestal that what a Lord is supposed to be. He is supposed to be our first priority. If you got a child that ain't trying to do right by the Lord, you pray for them and you keep it going. You don't go back there with them and you don't dwell in their midst. Because if you dwell in their midst, you'll be caught in hellfire too. And I'm not trying to go nowhere. I love my nieces and my nephew and my sisters, my mama, them, I surely do. But if they ain't living by the word, I gotta go. If you ain't trying to go to church, you're getting left. Because I gotta make it. I gotta come with my strength line. He said we got strength to one another. He said don't fail to assemble yourself with the saints. But we wanna stay home. We wanna act like that don't matter. Some of us even push it aside and say, oh, I go to church. I go to church next week. I'm not gonna go this month. Such and such gonna be preaching. I'm gonna go next month. The Bible says he don't have no respect to person. While we have a respect to person, while when certain people get up here and it's the truth, we don't want to receive it. Because it's because we're looking at the outward. We're looking at the outward
appearance.
See, even though the Lord do search your heart and he wants you to be clean inside and out, sometimes we can see that the vessel is holy and that they're living holy. But because they this person and we don't want to talk about it, we say we forgive everybody. But you got unforgiveness and you got hard in your heart towards that person, so you don't want to come to church.
Amen.
You say, oh, I'm not going to go listen to brother and sister so-and-so.
Amen.
They ain't talking about nothing.
Mm-hmm.
What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? It's the word.
Amen.
So you say you don't love the word?
Amen.
It ain't me, it's in the word.
Amen.
You say you don't have no respect to person, so why we got respect to person?
Amen.
We talking about, well, I just don't know about them. I just don't know about you. Dude, you ain't living holy either. You, at least they trying. They striving to earn the ring. But yeah, you sit home service after service. You come see who you want to see.
Amen.
You put money in the offering to whom you want to put money in the offering. What's wrong with you?
Amen.
Why you got so much respect to person? Why you so jealous? Because it really be a jealous spirit. You're mad. You're mad because they ain't calling you to. What you mad for? If you was living that life, maybe you could be up in too. But trust me.
Amen.
Everybody don't desire to be up in because I want to preach.
Amen.
I'm just going to tell you the truth. I said, I wasn't going to do it. But the Lord ain't not missing me. Thank you, Jesus. I'm just saying, people around here playing with the Lord.
Amen.
Just straight playing with the Lord. They live in one way this day and another way the next.
Amen.
And I had to get off the Instagram, y'all. I'm telling you. Lord had to help me. I was on there. I was watching some of the videos. My head just went to hurt. I was like, Lord, what is this? Everything that went real, my head would hurt when I watched it.
Amen.
So I had to get off of there. I couldn't keep it in my hair. I uninstalled it out. Now I just look at my little... Another little app to look at somebody's clothing, but I said, I ain't watching all these different people.
Amen.
I can't have an itching ear. Because once I start listening to it, that get in my heart.
Amen.
And if I'm not praying and seeking the Lord like I'm supposed to, that becomes me.
Amen.
And you see, I can't let everything enter into me.
Amen.
Even certain conversations, people be talking, they be like, you didn't hear what I said? No, I wasn't trying to hear. I'm telling that, but I wasn't trying to hear what you were saying. It wasn't nothing of the Lord.
Amen.
I can't hear that. I can't allow that stuff to enter into my spirit.
Amen.
I'm trying to make it to heaven.
Amen.
He said only the pure. He said blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
Amen.
I ain't trying to not see God because you are right. Everything, my conversation got to be holy.
Amen.
So if you're not holy, then what I'm doing around you, if I'm not trying to win your soul, then I shouldn't be around you.
Amen.
If I'm not talking to you about Jesus, then I shouldn't be talking to you at all.
Amen.
People want to put their conversations on the next thing that's coming out. You can't do that. You got to set your hope in eternal things. This word, it's an eternal thing.
Amen.
He said, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my work will remain.
Amen.
He said, nothing in this world going to fall. Nothing. But we want to switch the word. We want to get all our different versions of the word. People might want to get quiet, but it's the truth. Don't want to read the KJV.
Amen.
I don't understand it. The Lord said, any man lack of wisdom to ask of him, he'll give it to you liberally. So what's so hard to understand about it?
Amen.
I remember a time I couldn't understand it either. But when I actually got down to business with the Lord, and I said, Lord, look at here, I don't get what you're saying right here, what you're telling me I need to do. Amen. And he'll let you know. Amen. But we want to make excuses for our flesh. We want to say that, well, I don't understand it, so I don't got to do it. You understand just what that verse said, he told you not to do it. He said, no liar is going to have it, that every liar will have their part in the lake of fire. Y'all know what the word said? He said it. He don't say it like that, but he said you're going to hell if you're lying. He say it. I mean, and then you want to say, well, it wasn't really a lie. It was a field. That's a lie. It's a lie. A lie is a lie.
Amen.
He said every lie. Everybody that's filled with unbelief, see, you got to believe it with your whole. That's why I say with your whole heart. Because if you're not wholeheartedly in it, pieces of you won't believe it. You'll have doubt. Doubt will creep in into you. That's why you got to believe and trust on it with your whole heart. If you're out here doing stuff that you know you ain't got no business doing, then you're going in. That's point blank there. He say much is known, much is required.
Amen.
So why are you making excuses for yourself? Amen. And that's all that I have for y'all tonight.
Lord, that good word that she brought up.